Hi, I'm Yingying, and welcome back to USD in Bifrost. In the last tutorial, we learned how to create the USD stage in Bifrost. We created this prim monster, which contains two children, the body and the eyes. Today, we'll create a variant set of two flowers and add it to the stage. I'll also show you how to use Primvars to associate an attribute with geometric primitives like mesh vertices, which allows us to procedurally create variations such as color gradients and patterns. And you'll also learn how to save a USD stage. Now let's get started. This is where we left in the last tutorial. There's a link to this file in the description. First, let's create a prim of the type X-form using the node define USD prim. And name it flowers. This will be the container for the variants. To add a prim to an existing stage, we get another add to stage node. Connect the existing stage to it, and connect the prim that we just created to prim definitions. Expand settings, and here's where we specify the parent path for this new prim. In this case, we want the prim flowers to be a child of the prim monster, so we enter slash monster here. Connect the out stage to the output. If we look at the structure in the outliner, we see that now the monster has three children, body, eyes, and flowers. Before we define a variant set, let's create a prim for each type of the flowers. Let's hide the body and eyes for a moment. Here I have a model of a dandelion and a model of a tulip. Let's create the prim dandelion first. Hover your mouse over children, right-click, under Create Node, select Define USD Prim, and rename the path to dandelion. If you want to see the full path of a prim, first select the prim, and then go to the attribute editor, expand metadata, and you'll see the full path here. Now let's drag the flower and the stem of the dandelion into the Bifrost graph editor. Similar to how we created the eyes, we define a USD mesh for the dandelion flower, and another one for the stem. Let's rename them dandelion flower and dandelion stem. Connect the shapes to the USD meshes respectively and hide the original model. Remember how to change the color of a prim? Right-click at Attribute Definitions and select Define USD Display Color. Let's pick a yellow color for the flower. Get the same node for the stem. And make it green. To transform a prim, as we learned in the last tutorial, we can use the node define USD transform. We want to move the flower and the stem together, so let's do it at the dandelion level. Now we have our dandelion ready. To create a prim for the tulip, we follow exactly the same procedure. Drag the flower and stem into the Bifrost graph editor. And then we can just copy and paste all these nodes. change the names of the paths. And adjust the color and transformation. Now we see that the Primvars has two children, Dandelion and Tulip. To make them into a variant set, first go to the Primvars, right-click at Variant Set Definitions. Under Create Node, select Define USD Variant Set. Here it asks for the name of the set. Let's name it Flower Type. And here selection means the default selection of the variant set. For example, if we wanted to display the Dandelion before we make any selection, we should put the name of the Dandelion variant here. At this moment, we don't have the names for our variants yet. To name a variant, go to the Parameters panel of the variant. Under Variant Selection, we can give it a name here, say Dandelion. We also need to enter the name of the set that we defined earlier, which is Flower Type. Do the same for the Tulip. Let's name it Tulip and put the set name Flower Type here. Now let's go back to the node Define USD Variant Set and enter Dandelion for the default selection. Now in the viewport, we see that it only displays the Dandelion. If we go to the outliner, we see this letter V at the bottom right corner of the flowers icon, which means it's a variant set. And instead of the two children, Dandelion and Tulip, now we only see one child, Dandelion. If we right-click at flowers, go to Variant Set, Flower Type, and select Tulip, it switches to the tulip, and here we see that the child of the flowers is now Tulip. Let's select the USD proxy shape and turn shareable on so that we have direct access to the monster.usd layer. Let's take a look at it in the script editor. Here's the variant set flowers. This part is the current selection. Right now we have Dandelion selected, and we see that the string Dandelion is assigned to the variable flower type. If we switch to Tulip, we see that now Tulip is assigned to flower type. Here's the default selection, which is the Dandelion. And here are the definitions of all the variants. We have the Dandelion composed of its flower and stem, and the tulip as well. Creating variant sets allows us to easily switch between different options and quickly test our design ideas. Now let's move on to our second topic today, which is the Primvars. Last time we assigned the body of the monster with a solid color. What if we want some color variations, as shown in this picture? Through enabling Primvars, we can associate an attribute with the geometric primitives of the mesh, such as the vertices and faces, and this allows us to introduce variations by assigning different colors to different vertices or faces. I'll use this noise pattern as an example to demonstrate how to create color variations using Primvars. First, let's delete this Define USD Display Color. Right-click at Attribute Definitions and select Define USD Attribute. To define a color attribute, we use the name Display Color. Here, each vertex is assigned with one of the two colors based on the noise value sampled at its position. So the type of this color attribute should be color3f array, which is a flow3 array representing the RGB values of all the vertices. Check enable value. This allows us to provide values to the attribute. Under primvars, check enable primvar. and select Primvar vertex as the interpolation. And then we need to provide the color values for this attribute. With Primvar vertex selected, each value will be associated with the corresponding vertex. To generate the color values, we iterate through the vertices, and for each vertex, sample the noise field at its position. If the noise value is less than 0, it gets the pink color, otherwise the cyan color. We can use the node getMeshStructure to retrieve the information such as point count and positions. Here I've created a compound that takes the vertex positions and returns the color values. Let's connect point count to max iterations and point position to vertex positions. This compound is a forEach loop, which iterates through the vertex positions, and at each position, it samples the noise field. And then the noise value at this position is compared to 0. If it's less than 0, it outputs the pink color, otherwise the cyan color. Connect the output to the value port of the define attribute node, and we get the color pattern. Let's take a look at it in the script editor. Here's the array of the colors, one for each vertex. If we increase the face number of the original mesh, we get a higher resolution pattern. With the same logic, we can create all kinds of different color patterns. Here I've created a compound for generating a color gradient. And another one for generating a polka dot pattern. All the compounds are linked in the description. We can make these different patterns into a variant set as well. Disconnect this mesh prim body from its parent prim monster. Rename it to polka dot. This time we have three variants: polka dot, gradient, and noise. We need one mesh prim for each. Same as how we created the variant set for the flowers, get an add to stage node. Define a prim with the type xform as the container of all the variants. Let's name it body. And set the parent path to slash monster. Then define a USD variant set. Let's name the set body color. And set the default selection to noise. For each variant, we put its name here. And also enter the name of the set, which is body color. connect all these variants to the Prim body, and we have our variant set of different color patterns. If we look at the structure in the outliner, we see that the body prim is now a variant set, and we can choose between noise, gradient, and polka dot. This diagram shows the final structure of our USD stage. We have the prim monster, which has three children, the body, the eyes, and the flowers. The body and the flowers are variant sets. For the body, we can choose between the polka dot, gradient, and noise color patterns. And for the flowers, we have two options, the dandelion or the tulip. Finally, to save a USD stage, all we need is the node Save USD Stage. Insert it between the stage and the output. When we created the stage, we've already specified the path and the file name, so we don't need to put anything here. Just check Enable, and the stage will be saved in a .usd file, which we can use in other projects. That's it for today. In the next tutorial, we'll learn how to reference a USD stage and how to use scattering and instancing to create a gathering scene of our little friends. Thanks for watching, stay tuned, and I'll see you next time.